Evidence of early examples of batik have been found in the Far East, Middle East, Central Asia, and India from over 2,000 years ago. It's possible that these areas developed independently, without the influence of trade or cultural exchanges. However, it's more likely that the craft spread from Asia to the islands of the Malay Archipelago and the West to the Middle East along the caravan trading route. My inspiration comes from the Black Datura flower. The Black Datura flower is different from other flowers. It's highly poisonous and has a hallucinogenic effect. Its flower language is darkness, death, and revenge. But I think the Black Datura flower is unique in nature. No other flower can defend itself like the Datura. Next is the process of making batik. First, trace the desired pattern with a pencil. Then, trace the pencil pattern with melted wax. And finally, color it. Coloring the batik is my favorite part because the wax used in batik is close, is able to carry the fluidity of pigments so that the fluidity of pigments on the clothes can create new colors. According to my batik, you can see that the theme I chose is very unique. Where everyone chose bright flowers, I chose to paint the flower black. Black represents taboo, because I really like the theme of mystery, death, and darkness like the Black Datura. I use the two flowers as the main body of the design, surrounded by the leaves for decoration. But at the same time, I put two seemingly opposite elements, black and pink, together, representing the opposition between harmless and dangerous. I think this is an interesting collision. Black can give people feelings of despair, mystery, and unknown danger, while pink can give people feelings of comfort and security. Using black and pink as the main body of the design can produce a strong visual impact and attract the audience's attention. At the same time, black and pink represent different emotions and can express complex emotions, deep and tender themes.